starts now, because The View is live. It's Guide 8 Friday, and guess who's our first guest co-host of the season?
The Mooch.
Moochie.
The Mooch!
President Trump's former communications director, Anthony Scaramucci, is putting his spin on hot topics and his hasty exit from the White House. Spicer speaks out.
You resign the day that Anthony Scaramucci was hired.
I did.
He claims there's bad blood between him and Scaramucci, and we're getting answers straight from the Mooch. Plus, Little Big Town just scored 4 CMA nominations, and they're showing you why when they hit our stage. Here come Hot Topics with Joy Behar, Sarah Haynes, Sunny Hostin, Paula Ferris, and guest co-host Anthony Scaramucci. Now, let's get things started.
View. Joining us is on our Guide Day Friday guest host. Please welcome the man who made American history for the shortest term as White House Communications Director, Anthony Scaramucci.
Thank you.
And this is that your mom?
His mother immediately gave you a standing ovation.
I like
ovation.
That. Your mom is here, and you have like 50 of your cousins here.
I had
as
half
well.
The fans in here. Who knew what was going to happen, right?
The whole Mooch clan is here?
Exactly. Yeah.
Are they all Mooches?
We bust them in. Thanks for showing up, Mom. Thanks for showing up. Okay, great.
Oh, my God. You know, her attitude and her that standing ovation speaks volumes about being an Italian mother and what, right. you're, what yeah. you've turned out to be like.
Well,
what did I mean by that? Nobody even know what I meant.
I did. She jumped to her feet. She loves her kids.
She loves her boys.
Not emotional, but, you know, I love her to death. She's struggling with the leukemia.
Oh, sorry.
And she's doing a great job.
Yeah, so, but no, but anyway. You're a confident, yeah. A confident guy.
And you know, this one, she's got this battle. Yeah.
As soon as I heard the news that you got sacked, yeah. I got on the phone to you. That's I was true. The first one to call you.
Well, she beat you. I'm just letting you know.
You called phone... Joy Behar before no, you called your mother.
No, I called him.
The phone
him.
Was ringing. You I was at the him. Trump Hotel.
And he answered, Ma!
You reached, so she reached you before your own
okay,
mother?
I'm going to tell you why. She called on an unknown number. My mother always calls on an unknown number. So I said, Ma. She goes, no, it's not Ma. It's Joy Behar. I'm like, Joy Behar? I said, what are you doing calling me? She goes, all right, you just got fired. Are you coming on the show?
That's it. I'm booking the show. Yeah.
So we had a great conversation.
Yes,
I
we
thought,
did, huh? Which was off the record. I never said a word.
No, she yeah. did. She did. Well,
you were good about that, Joy.
You know what?
You're one Italian that was at least off the record.
Omerta. Omerta is my middle name.
Yeah.
Very good.
So, Paula, by the way.
Yes, Joy.
My dear. I am so happy to see
Ma.
You two today.
Yes.
Ma. You just did an interview with another ex-Trump staffer,
yes.
Sean Spicer.
Mm-hmm.
And I watched the clip, which we're going to see a clip. It looks like, Anthony, he has it over here for you.
Yeah.
Watch.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
You resign. The day that Anthony Scaramucci was hired.
I did.
Was his hiring the impetus for leaving?
Yes.
Why?
I've known Anthony for a while, not close, but I knew who he was. I just don't think that he had the skill set and the qualifications and the background to play a leading role in crafting the communications message and team. I don't believe, and I still don't believe, that he had the skill set and the experience for that job.
Are you surprised he lasted 10, 11 days?
Not after some of the things that occurred.
So he said that you yeah. weren't experienced enough. What do you say to that?
So here's the problem. Here's the problem with the Republican Party. Yeah. We have Republican on Republican crime all the time.
Yeah.
Okay, the Democrats, you know, maybe they don't like each other, but they're in solidarity. And so what I could do right now is I could hit back at him, but I'm not going to hit back at
take
him.
Take the high road.
No, it's not even that I'm going to take the high road. What I'm going to say is that we got to get it together. Okay, as a nation, we got to get it together. Okay, we may be. Maybe different. We may have different points of view. We may have different political points of view. But we got to cut the nonsense now and get it together. So he's entitled to his opinion. You guys know I have my opinion, okay? And I had a specific job from the President of the United States. And frankly, I think I carried out a lot of that job.
Yeah.
So,
Do you feel that you were qualified for the job?
For the communications job?
Yes.
Well, let's put it this way. The President asked me to do some specific things for him. That office was open, so I took the office. And I tell you, I put a full-blown communications plan together for him, which got released on the internet. You can take a look at it. Mm-hmm. And I think that Hope Hicks, who is a phenomenal person, is doing a very good job for the President. I talked to her yesterday. She was in New York 2 days ago, I guess, for the UN meeting.
But when they interviewed you, right, you were on TV right after you got the job, and you kept saying, I love the guy, love the guy, love the guy. You said it 20 times. I thought you were, like, a little over the top. Do you really love the guy?
I do. I have a lot of affection. Hold on a second. You guys, I've watched the show, so I know Whoopi's not here. I know Whoopi really loves the guy, right? I mean, really loves him. But here's what I would say about the President. He's trying to do the right thing. You guys may disagree with him, but I was on the campaign with him. There is economic desperation in our society. There's economic anxiety. I told you in the green room, there are only two candidates that really identified that. That was Bernie Sanders and Donald Trump. They really saw what I saw on the campaign trail, which is people that I grew up with that weren't educated, that were struggling to find jobs.
So why didn't you love Bernie Sanders then?
I didn't dislike Bernie Sanders.
But I mean,
I've been a Republican my whole life. I started with Scott Walker. I then gravitated to Jeb Bush. When it became clear that Mr. Trump, now President Trump, was going to win the presidency, I'm a team player, and I went over to work for him.
But people would call that opportunism rather than being a team player, because you also said on Fox Business, which I respected, you said he was a hack politician and his rhetoric was anti-American.
I love
you
these
also
ABC
said
people.
You also said that Trump was on track to be president of the Queens County Bullies Association.
Yeah, what about that?
And I agreed with you.
Those were 3 minutes of verbal infamy, okay? I definitely said that.
But you said
John
that.
Paul, your colleague, brought that up in my press conference. He read that out. I said, hey, listen, we have to remember the backstory of that, okay? He was hitting the hedge fund industry, so he started the fight. I hit back,
we made peace. Did you believe what you were saying?
Well, I was sore at him. I don't think that, you have to understand something. There's, you tell me the number of thousands of people that are in the hedge fund industry. Mm-hmm. I don't think we should be doing that. We don't need to be desecrating industries. I think that what we do in our society is we two-dimensionalize people and we caricaturize people in a way that they don't.
But when did that turn? When did all of that turn to this love you suddenly had?
I spent a lot of time with him on the campaign. Traveled around with him on the plane. got to know him a lot better personally. And again, you may not like the President personally, but I do think he's trying to do a lot of the right things.
Well, you said a lot behind the scenes, actually, that I could feel that you really respect the mission and some of the things he's saying, and you were privy to information that some of it we weren't. Mm-hmm. A lot that we weren't. So I can definitely tell you believe in what he's doing.
Listen, it's a very complex world. You guys have had President Obama on the show. You know that it's a very, very tough job. I wanted President Obama to succeed, even though I'm a Republican. I hope that Democrats want the President to succeed because it is our country.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
And we got to get together. We got to pull the thing together to help each other.
You don't want him to succeed in things that go against, really, the American people, like this crazy health care bill that they're trying to push. You don't want him to succeed at everything.
Yes. You're all about taking the high road today, and you talk about Republican, non-Republican crime. There were reports of so much infighting, and I know you talk about taking the high road, but it doesn't sound like that was happening, possibly in your stint at the White House. I want you to listen to one more clip.
No question.
Yeah. There were also reports that he was calling you Melissa McCarthy behind your back, which I can imagine pretty offensive.
Well, in some ways, but she won an Emmy, so I've been called a lot worse.
Was it true?
I don't know. I didn't spend a ton of time tracking down people calling me names. Look, I got to be honest with you. I don't spend a ton of time listening to the haters.
Wasn't true.
No, that wasn't true.
You never called him Melissa McCarthy.
I was calling him Liar Spice from the Spice Girls. I wasn't calling him a Melissa McCarthy.
Okay. Totally different name.
Totally different name. I
that
don't remember
been
calling
funny,
him.
Though.
Was anybody else calling him Melissa McCarthy?
Oh, definitely, yeah.
Yeah, funny. Definitely. Well,
hey,
you know,
listen, it's obvious, and you can see from your interview with him that we've had our differences.
Clearly.
And by the way, you know, a lot of these guys weren't full believers on the whole Trump train, even going into the election. On election day, some of them left New York City.
You couldn't stand Rex Priebus. You had a name for him.
Well, see, that's a weird story, okay? Because I actually got along with him while I was donating money to the Republican.
You know what you said.
Take a look.
My question to you is...
We only had 10 days to go from, so...
Right, you only had 10 days, but I'm a pretty straight-up guy, so I don't really think I made up that much. I sort of told the truth about a lot of different things.
And you said that's what got you in trouble in the first place.
Definitely.
Yeah.
But we're not using you as a comic prop until later. We'll be right back with more Hot Topics.
You need a strong voice to be heard in Hot Topics.
Let's hear it for the ladies.
I'm the first working mother to ever hold this job.
Who voice different views and come here to be heard.
I want this country to go in a new and different direction.
What matters most is what happens next.
Rocking their view. Strong.
This president is going to be incredible for this country.
I am not running for anything except the impeachment of Trump.
So that happened.
Oh, you never know what'll happen on
The View.
The View, y'all.
We appreciate the platform and The View.
Take a little time to enjoy The View.
Still ahead. Country superstars Little Big Town are performing their latest hit live on The View.
This was an interesting thing we found out this morning. More women than ever are cheating on their husbands. Yeah. Like, there's been a 40% spike since 1990.
That's a lot.
It could it be that, you know, monogamy is more boring than being trapped in an elevator with Steve Mnuchin?
Oh, come on.
I mean...
That was by Steven.
Well, what are they saying is the reason, though? Is it because they're feeling more empowered, or... Often they love their husbands but feel that their needs, sexual, emotional, and psychological, are not being met inside the
marriage. That everything?
Yeah, yes. Pretty much.
Sexual, emotional.
Yeah, I think resentment's a big thing, too.
Yeah.
When women feel like they're bringing home the bacon and frying it, too. Like, I tell my husband, I'm like, I don't want to say thank you for doing that. Thanks for helping out, because this is a partnership.
Yeah.
And women start to resent those women that are working full-time. I know for me, I'm like, just do a little bit more around the house. You know, I'm taking the kids to every single doctor's appointment.
Yet I think we haven't gotten off what we expect from women traditionally. Mm-hmm. So we have this kind of head-to-head thing of we're both working, but now we're still expecting me to cook and clean and take care of the kids.
Let me ask you, you've been married.
I lost my voice. Excuse me, ladies.
No, but you've been married, right? A couple of times,
yes,
correct?
Yes, I have.
So what kind of husband?
Heading for the Frank Sinatra record. Go ahead.
Are you a traditionalist?
Well, okay, so you guys met my mom. You met her in the green room.
Yeah. Marie Dolores,
She did pick up after me. So what do you think's going on in the house? Okay, the stuff's being thrown everywhere.
Are you a mama's boy?
Okay, Joy,
yes,
am I a mama's boy,
is.
Joy? What's the answer to that?
Well, you know, the Italian boys, a lot of times they stay with the mommy. They're my mamone.
Didn't they call them?
I heard that you call me a mamone, Joy. Who's my mama's boy?
A mamone is somebody who, you know, they stay home with the mother. They send the laundry. Even if they don't live with their mothers, they send the laundry to do
it. So maybe you want someone to step in for her, like kind of like hand the baton off to another woman to help you out?
Is it that then, as mothers, because I have a boy, am I...
He hasn't been able to respond.
Are we making, you know, our boy... boys grow up into men that are still little boys.
Yeah.
Are you a little boy? Is that what we're doing?
Totally a little boy. Especially around the house, okay? But let me just say this to you, okay? The best thing you can do as a guy, in my opinion, is say thank you and show the appreciation.
Now, you could take out the garbage. Yeah. You could fix your bed.
But I also think
you could change a diaper.
When you're saying thank you and your actions are tied to words like taking out the garbage and things like that, things go a little bit better.
But you know, the other reason that they use is because a lot of women are children of divorce. I'm a child of divorce. My parents were divorced. And the last thing that I would ever put my children through is a divorce. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so they're staying in these marriages because they don't want to happen to their children what happened to them.
And
that makes a lot of sense.
That's interesting because I begged my parents to get divorced.
You did? Why?
They just think they were so ill-suited.
Really?
My father was so ill-suited. My mother liked the opera. My father liked the ponies. You know what I mean?
But they were ill-suited. They didn't get a divorce.
No, I wish they would have.
Catholic.
But yeah, I'm Catholic too. But you know, the other thing that's interesting about this is that the men don't know that the 40% of women are cheating. Now, do you think if the husbands found out, they'd stay in the marriage?
Oh, yeah. Right.
Did you ever find out?
I think it's like,
answerable question.
Wait,
that you
did that
just
come out of my mouth?
Bring the fan.
Let me bring it back. Would you stay?
I think the world's very complicated, and I think that people, I'm Catholic, so I believe in redemption, I believe in forgiveness, so I think the answer is a qualified yes, okay, but there's a lot of factors that go into marriage, so what I've learned long ago that I never judge other people's relationships, because you don't know what's going on inside that relationship. So I try not to throw rocks and stones at people in the relationships. I certainly don't want my relationships judged, and I don't want to judge other people's relationships, but we have a tendency to sometimes do that to each other.
Yeah. You got out of that one really big.
He really
you
are right qualified back. For that.
The Official View Store is open 24/7. So for mugs, merch, and more, go to our website, click on the store, and see how good the view looks all over you.
A lot of Republicans don't believe in science. Is that right?
That's how we're starting the segment.
No, I'm just saying. They don't. They don't believe in global warming and climate change and everything. They deny science, which is annoying. But
this science isn't really comparable.
But this is a scientific experiment that we read about. And that is that it answered the question, why don't people like you? Why wouldn't somebody like a person?
There's science behind it?
Yes, it had some scientific background.
They wasted science time checking with it, okay?
So really there are certain good things that people do not will make you unlikable.
See, like you, Joy. There's a couple here.
Go ahead.
Oh, pestering. No. You'll recognize it. Pestering people about their ethical choices. Paula, how much does she poke the bear with you? She does it to Sunny too.
Yeah. Not a ton, but she does.
The ethical choices, she talks about your ministry time. She talks about.
But I don't feel like she's challenging it.
She's poking you.
No, but.
Yes, she is. And then she is.
Have you been poking me this whole time and I didn't know?
The other thing she does is she corrects people's grammar constantly.
And spelling.
The grammar police.
I was an English teacher. Mm-hmm. So when someone says to me, I feel badly, that's incorrect, and I have to correct them.
Do
you say I feel badly?
You're like a verbal proofreader. Go ahead, keep going. Yeah.
Could care less or couldn't care less?
I couldn't care less is correct.
I wanted to hear from Anthony.
Oh, from him.
I would probably say, look, I grew up in a neighbor. I'd probably say I could care less, and she would yell at me.
And she would yell.
No, that's okay. I'll let you get away with that one.
She never.
It's the badly that makes me crazy.
Why does it make you crazy?
Because you wouldn't say to somebody, I feel sadly. And it's you can't say I feel sadly.
Feeding
it's a feeling. It's
science just told us people are not liking her right
when
now.
When you use an L-Y at the end of it, it means though, I feel that's badly. Like I'm.
What if I feel bigly?
Well, she's also. That's bad.
No.
Again, incorrect English. No, I think they've decided that is a word.
Bigly. You also are super. This other one says
it's said it and then you're laughing.
If you're the cheeriness, if you're too cheerful.
That's you.
That's you. Joy, you're so cheerful and positive all the time.
Shut up. That's you.
She's like the cheer.
That was a joke.
Now, listen, Anthony, person. The one thing that I think you told me in the backstage, humble bragging annoys you.
Yeah, that goes on Wall Street all the time. Oh, I've got dust on my yacht. Or, you know, I just fixed my Ferrari outside by my ranch.
Do you call people out on it?
You don't call people out on it, but it's sort of revolting.
So what do you do?
What do you think? You just shake your head. You're like, oh, brother. You know, okay, we know you're rich. Take it easy, okay? We're all the same.
Who is the most annoying, horrible person in the Oval Office? The most unlikable. Come on.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I would pick two.
Okay.
Not just one.
Wait, drum roll.
Twofer.
Come on.
Okay.
How do you think I got along with Reince Priebus and Steve Bannon? You thought that was a good relationship?
I knew it was
Steve Bannon. You thought we were triumvirate, the three of us?
No.
I mean, that was rough.
What was Bannon's worst quality, in your opinion?
He's scary.
Well, I mean, Steve, his best quality is he's a great speechwriter. He's got a great linguistic skills. You wouldn't have to prove.
He wouldn't say I feel badly.
He wouldn't have to do that.
I don't think he feels.
His worst quality to me was that he had a little bit of a messianic complex.
Oh, yeah.
He got very mad at me for going to Davos, Switzerland to speak at the World Economic Forum, which was sanctioned by the communications team. But because he's an anti-globalist and he was hitting that economic forum at Breitbart for so many years, that put me in disfavor with him.
Oh.
And so, you know, people have messianic complexes. They think they're the answer. They think they're the solution. And what we know about our country and we know about our government, thank God, it's set up a system of checks and balances where it has to be a collaboration.
Yeah, no, there's not much checks and balances.
People also say he's a white right nationalist.
Now. You see, a white nationalist. He
do you
has,
want to go to commercial or do you want
no,
to answer
No, no, we don't
that.
Have to go to commercial on
we
that.
We got
to
go.
I would say that he's...
go ahead.
You got to go? Okay, well, no, I would say that he has those tendencies. If you read Breitbart, there's a lot of that white nationalist
economic fervor.
Well, he's
white and he's
fervor.
A nationalist. And put so, both together.
To me, my whole thing is, doesn't matter, we're a rainbow, let's grow the pie, let's share the pie
let's
together.
Let's eat the pie.
But
we'll
let's
be right
get
back.
To work.
I'm hungry.
Go.
Next, we have a special surprise guest the Mooch has no idea about, and it's going to leave him speechless.
Every member of Trump's cabinet has been impersonated by somebody. famous. Alec Baldwin just won an Emmy for doing Trump.
Yeah.
And Melissa McCarthy won for her uncanny impression of Sean Spicer. So, Mooch, let me ask you something. Nobody's really done you, maybe a little bit, one person. Who's your favorite?
Well, I think Bill Hader did me on Saturday
yes.
Live.
Mm-hmm.
Mario
right.
Cantone did me on...
Who do you like better?
The American... Well, obviously, Mario Cantone. You love Trump.
Sit down.
Hey,
I don't
come
love.
On.
I don't. Sit, look at this guy. It's my doppelganger. It's my doppelganger. Wasn't that the name of the movie that Ted Cruz was watching?
Shush.
Doppelganger. Thanks for having me the whole hour, Joy. I really appreciate it. Not used to sticking around that long in any one place.
You need to listen to me.
Unless there's free hors d'oeuvres and a two drink
mix. You need a little more bronzer.
Don't make me smack you in front of company. This is a big career break for me.
Now I know why I changed my tie.
This is a big... we got the same tie. Let me tell you.
How bummed were you when I got fired, though?
I was...
Right? I mean, you were on your way, and then they got shot like a little bird.
Let me tell you something.
Right? You had to be bummed,
you're
right?
Lucky you're here with... You got nothing. Spicer got the Emmys. You're sitting here with four bleeding heart get-get-owns.
It's a hand.
Can't get on this by hand.
Okay.
You know, there's not a lot of job security in the White House. You got Spicy, Reince, Bannon. I want to say something to Sarah Huckabee Sanders. It's an old Italian expression my mother used to use when things weren't meant to last. Rent, don't buy.
Oh, she's going to make it.
You think so?
Sarah's great.
He said she's good.
Fine.
She gives that advice to
she's
Melania.
All right. Look, I didn't love being there either. You know, I had zero friends in the White House. What was I supposed to do? Go to Jimmy Swaggart's dinner party with Mike Pence? Would have facials with Steve Bannon? I'm not going to do that. I love Donald Trump. I love him. I love him. I'd give the man this shirt off my back if I didn't think he'd get ketchup and self-tanner all over it. Let me tell you. I love the, there's an old Italian expression.
Another one?
There's many of them, many of them. I love
better,
the president, and this old Italian expression goes like this. The more orange the cheese, the more repeats on you. He's like right here, he's like Ajita. Like Ajita, right here. Like Ajita, right here. Okay, I admit it, the president doesn't know a lot about foreign policy. Come on, he doesn't. I had to tell him that Kim Jong-un didn't have siblings named Kim, Chloe, and Courtney.
All right, Mario, I'm going to cut you off. Because... thanks to Mario Cantone. We're running out of time.
Can
here,
I get
so...
out of this character? Can I get him outside of me right now? This is horrifying that I have to do this in front of your mother. This is really horrifying.
You feel...
it's
you.
Terrible. Because look, she looks just like my family.
Mom, blow it's Mario a kiss.
No. He's cute. Wait, we have a fun game we want to play with
Marissa.
You guys.
Thanks for giving birth to me, Mom.
Okay, so since
you'd have had a much better life if she did.
Since the White House stint was short for both of you, we never really got to see you in action. So we want to play a game with you both called Spin It with the Mooch. Here's how it works. Anthony, you will press this button, which spins spins a digital wheel of fake news headlines. Whichever headline it lands on, you'll give us your official response of how you would have handled it as communications director. Then move number two, you'll tell us your response.
Did I give you that?
Hurry up, we only have a minute.
Okay.
Let's go.
Headline number one. The first lady admits she voted for Hillary. Anthony, spin it.
Made a mistake in the ballot. Sometimes that happens. She was in there moving very quickly. And let's face it, this Secretary Clinton's not a bad person. But thank God my husband's the president. That's the official statement.
Mooch number two. Spin it.
Look, cut her some slack. The girl never voted before. She comes from a third world republic where they vote by throwing a rock at a goat.
Number two, the president renames the Lincoln bedroom Putin's pad. Anthony, go.
It's just for this one night. I'm sure we're going to convince the president. We're going to move it back to Lincoln next week.
Okay, Mario. Number two.
Well,
that's you.
Well, you know, so what? It's Putin's pad. Big deal. Just bring some rubles so you can put it in the slot to make the bed vibrate.
Okay, we got to go.
Okay.
Thanks so much to Mario Cantone and, of course, the Mooch. We'll be right back.
Hey, y'all. We're Little Big Town. We're coming out. We're almost there.
Thank you. Next week on The View, what happens when Sofia Vergara, Larry David, Kristen Chenoweth, Adam Scott, and Craig Robinson hit the table?
Hashtag crazy.
Plus 50 cents in the house.
Come on, put some 50 in your morning. Let's get it going.
Oh, yeah. It's getting hot. And the topics are, too. It's all next week on
The View, y'all.
On ABC. Career CMA nomination, including Album of the Year, for their new CD, The Breaker. Please welcome Little Big Town. By saying huge congratulations on being inducted into the Nashville Walk of Fame. Now, you guys have won tons of awards over the years, but what does this one mean to you?
Wow. Well, first of all, we were utterly shocked when we heard about it, but it's such an honor. We have a star by Dolly Parton.
That's true.
Well, also huge, Kimberly, Keith Urban did the honors, saying you guys are, quote, the closest thing to a family band that are not related that you'll ever meet. And that's something you set out to do from the very beginning, right?
We sure did. Yeah.
We we've been friends for 30 years this year, I guess.
Since we were in kindergarten. Right.
Since we were wee little ones. Yeah, so... and then I ended up marrying this one.
So you kind of became
family. Yeah. But, you know, we raised babies together on the buses, and they always tour with us. And when we start the Breakers tour coming out this year, they'll be back on the road with us again.
They're on the bus.
Kimberly, we haven't seen you since you added to your family.
Yeah.
You had a little baby Dolly.
I do have a little Dolly.
Oh.
She's she likes to chew on spatulas.
They do this.
In the kitchen.
I wonder why.
It's always a new adventure.
You?
I have a little girl coming too.
Little girls. Oh my goodness. This is my second little girl.
I feel like there need to be more warnings for the boys, right? The girls.
I think, well, yeah. You have a little boy, don't you?
Yeah, she already has a boy. I'm still in shock.
The main thing different between little boys, I mean, they have a little boy, so that's how, my only experience, but little girls are quite dramatic. But that's okay.
Well, I expected that. Do you know where her mother is?
Yeah, right, right.
They're sophisticated.
Precious. Yes.
Now, you also just announced a new tour.
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about that.
We're out with our good friends Midland, new band, and Casey Musgraves, who we toured with before. And they're just both phenomenal. Casey's one of the, I think, one of the finest young new voices in country music. She's a very important person to come along, and I think her music just speaks for itself. It's so poignant and true and relevant, and we're going to have a great time. Yeah. Midland just had a number one song with Drinking Problem. And
their record comes out this week.
Yeah. And we're gonna have, it's a big family. It's a
big family. Delay here to perform When Someone Stops Loving You off the CD The Breaker. Give it up for Little Big Town. Woo!
Still gotta walk into a crowded room with the radio. To crack a smile and crack a beer like it don't bother you, like it ain't your song. It's on. Still gotta cross the bridge to get to work, the one by her place. Make it through the 9 to 5 like it don't hurt. It goes that way when someone stops and loves. Don't keep the sun from rising, clock rewinding, heart beating, even when you wanted to. When someone stops loving you, still gotta button up your collared shirt, the one she used to button down. On the mattress where her body left a curve, or maybe just the couch. Still gotta keep a number in your phone in case she calls back one night when she's drunk and all alone. Yeah, you pray for that someone starts loving you. It don't make the evening news. It don't keep the sun from rising, not from whining, not from beating, even when you want it to. When someone stops loving you, switch that you can flip, cause you can't stop loving them. When someone stops loving you, when someone stops loving you, you don't keep the sun around, half a whining, half a beating, even when you want it to. When someone stops loving you.
Superstar Curtis 50 Cent Jackson is given his 2 cents at the Hot Topics table and a brand new View Your Deal Oprah edition with her favorite things for fall.
Welcome back. So Anthony, Have you had a nice time today?
I had a fantastic time.
Really?
That was great.
Come back again?
I wish you were sitting closer to me.
Why?
I don't know. There's like an
warm
affection
fuzzies.
I have for
you're
you.
You're so warm. Affection.
You were the first person I talked to after I got fired. I feel close to you.
Yeah. Look, I like you. I like you. Yeah. And I really would like you to return to the party that you belong in, which is the Democratic Party. No, his brother's going no. That's what he really is. On his heart, he's a Democrat.
Yeah. I'm a socially inclusive, fiscally responsible.
Okay, well, take a little time to enjoy the view.